Oh, you could be mistaken for turning your television on and thinking this was a race in March or April with good weather, because the classics guys are at the front. Thomas Bouda has infiltrated them. Very good, promising young rider from Diait Energie. There's Guillaume van Kerspolk, Nicky Terpstra, but there's no cobbles here. Not too much in the crosswind action either. Luke Durbridge and Matthew Heyman. It's a very good group up the road, but behind, it's one of the last chances to win a stage at the Tour de France.
As we start to see a loss in Craddock.
I was going to say, I'm just mouthing, Craddock?
Yeah.
Just to make sure my eyes weren't deceiving me.
Oh, and bumps and bruises when the pace changed. And Adam Yates is one of those. Quintana's also on the deck. Oh, my goodness, the Austrian champion also just picking himself up. There is Quintana, and you can see he's carrying a really nasty knock. It's swollen up. Looks like he's smuggling in a golf ball in that elbow. Not pleasant indeed. 18 kilometres to go. I think there's enough strength in the peloton, although it is strung out because of that move, to make sure that this does end in a bunch sprint. On the left shoulder of Peter Sagan, you can see the European champion is tucked in there, and John Degenkolb's in a great place as well. This is outstanding. How will this one finally be delivered? Just offering up some shoulders. Absolutely fantastic. Fabulous. Let's wait and see. Damar's also in the frame here, but so are plenty of others as well. And looking for a late dig here is actually Taylor Finney's in the mix here, would you believe, for Education First. It's being here's the let go then, and here's the big turn. If you're in a decent position, once we emerge from this, and a little shimmy there, a correction it was from Chris Hoff, just getting into Edvald Boasenhagen, who had to keep it safe and did so. There's the compression. It's not a pleasant place to be. So what have you got? Chris Hoff is just on the back wheel of Damar. For the time being, two from Coffin is still involved here as well. Christophe Laporte's in a very good place. So is indeed Degenkolb, who's waiting to light it up. Hasn't done so just yet. And here we go. It's Coffin is to pick it up with 700 metres to go, Sean.
Yes, we can see it's Diven who is leading. And we can see Degenkolb there is in about four position. We can see Dimension Data also very much up there. So as we go into the final 500 metres.
Here we are. Big pickup there. And it's time to make your investment. If you've got anything to play with, and Laporte it is that for Coffin is just tucked in at the moment, and here comes Degenkolb. Sorry, I beg your pardon. Here comes Damar. Damar being led in absolutely beautifully. What's Christophe got? What's Edvald Boasenhagen got? They spear either side. Laporte's not out of it either. Damar's got to deliver. His team have done all the work today. Is he going to finish it off for them? Laporte coming. He tries to balk him. Oh, and he makes it count. Laporte will complain about that, you can be sure. Some lateral movement late on. But Arno Demar reaches the line first, and that'll be a cathartic moment for him. His team did so much work today.
Arno Demar, tellement de kilomètres de souffrance, de combat pour un instant comme ça, ça vaut le coup.
Arno, so many kilometers of suffering, and then you get here. Is it worth it? Well, yeah, it's totally worth it. In the tough moments, you always think there might be this opportunity, there might be this chance, and I'm not the best climber, but I had good legs at the end of today's stage. I gave it my all. I believed in myself. I gave it everything. I felt that I might have the possibility of winning, and it's the last sprint, of course, before the Champs-Élysées, and now it's happened. The team's done a great job to get me there. And my family, my wife and friends who have supported me all the way around this Tour de France, yeah, they've really helped as well, and I dedicate my victory to them. And in front of Laporte and Christophe, you did a really fast sprint, didn't you? Well, yeah, 10K from the finish line, we were going really fast. And everyone just kept on pushing, and we were going full gas, and I was really feeling I was right on the limit, but I was in such a great position, and because the team did such an amazing job to put me in there at the end, it was, well, it was quite easy to finish off. So, for you, the Tour is now a big success already, but now there's the Champs-Élysées. I mean, do you want to win there as well? Yep, everything that I've trained for, I really, really want to work hard for this win, but yeah, of course, the Champs would be a bonus.
Yeah, it was a solid start. It definitely was an easy day. We were on the pedals all day, and yeah, like you say, it was a hot day, which made it tough, and obviously a really fast final as well. A bit stressful, but yeah, happy to get through it.
Tomorrow, the fireworks will continue. How worried are you not to be able to keep that form for 3 weeks? Do you think about it sometimes?
Well, not really. I try to just think of day by day, but yeah, obviously it's one more big day, a big, big day, and we're expecting a lot of attacks. You know, it's a lot of climbing. It's going to be a hard day, but we've ridden really well together as a team so far, so hopefully we can keep that going.
Are you expecting attacks on the final climb and on the descent, or maybe something from Romain Bardet from early on?
Yeah, we're expecting the worst, really. Just guys trying to go in the early break, attacks maybe on Tourmalet, and obviously the final climb and descent. And so we're just going to be ultra vigilant, stay on our toes, and we'll keep doing what we've been doing.
Yeah, and counting on the help of all your teammates in Sky.
100%, yeah. Hopefully they can guide me through it. Hopefully I just can stay strong in the wheels, and yeah, we'll see how it goes.